Holocaust survivors and Wallenberg. Is the physical cornerstone. But the spiritual cornerstone of the museum, entry to Anne Frank's diary, dated July 15, 1944. The truth can be shattered. I truly wonder that I haven't dropped all my ideas, because they seem so absurd and impossible to carry out. Millions that were silenced, this voice, no louder than a child's whisper. It has outlasted the shouts of the murderers and has soared above the voices of time.
Offering spirit to continue to inform and move generations who will not have more witness, as Leon Bass did. Mr. President, ladies
and a young man began to tell us about Buchenwald. And he made me aware that these people were Jews. They were gypsies. And they were communists. And they were a litany of people who somehow, according to the Nazi standards, were not good enough. And therefore they were placed here as items that were expendable.
Standards poses a challenge to all Americans. I look forward to joining you, President Reagan, and his successor for the ceremonies marking the opening of the United States Holocaust Memorial Museum. You have my September day. Out of our memory and understanding of the Holocaust, we must forge an unshakable oath with all civilized people that never again will the world... I'd like now to introduce to you the
kindness and truth have not forsaken you. So shall you find grace and good favor in the sight of God and man. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Memory of the 6 million fresh and enduring. We who did not go their way owe them this. We must make sure their deaths have posthumous meaning. We must make sure that we're understanding. Some people even say that the word evil is insufficient to describe the Holocaust, and instead they use terms like mad. That may have been the ultimate purpose of those who made the Holocaust, a grotesque effort to hurl the earth into the very tip of the serpent. I believe the Holocaust and Catholics and Protestants who understand information and knowledge on this necessary subject. It will examine the nature and meaning of the continuing curse that is anti-Semitism. I think all of us here are aware of those even among our own is still being distributed and in some cases taught in school. This, the most profoundly cynical piece of anti-Semitic filth ever produced, is full of libels toward the Jewish people, against the Jewish people, is a blood libel against all humankind, and no decent person will stand for it. We,
and all Americans of goodwill, are united in the challenge I propose to the Soviet leaders today. I say, let these people go. Jews. Pass their blessings and remind them. And like many of the camp ballads, it was not about the hunger and the torture and the dying, but about the coming of the Messiah. What will happen, we saw Mass, when the Messiah comes? The answer is, when the Messiah comes, we'll have a banquet. And the banquet is...
Chairman Meyerhoff has just escorted the President over to the Senate.
But?
And the President is...
It's on the other side. There you go.
To unveil.
Scott, they're cutting
the cornerstone.
And all you just do is...
And
thank you, Rabbi. Thank you, Mr. President.